Father, thank you for all that you have done, all you are doing, and all that you're about to do. We hear to hear your word, to receive it. We believe it, that we may be a doer of it. You increase. We decrease. And Father, we give you praise, honor, and glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, I can tell you one thing that just blessed me beyond words is the love of Father that I can literally sense through the tangible anointing, which is the manifestation of the Holy Spirit, who comes to just bring in manifestation everything that the Lord is and has done. One God in three persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And He's the Spirit of grace, the Spirit of love. And I can tell you that the more I serve Him, the more I stand in awe of Him. I can tell you that when I prayed for the people, you know, you always feel the virtue coming forth, the dunamis power, His touch coming on people. Like, I don't know how to explain it. Jesus, when the woman with the issue of blood touched Him, He said He felt virtue coming forth. And I felt on Thursday night, the Holy Spirit had me put my hand on everybody's heart, like that. I was just the heart. Hallelujah. It was just the most precious thing, the Holy Spirit. Just, and then when I woke up Friday and going home in awe, I said, and I'm mentioning that to you because He's going to do that to you today. And I said, Father, what was that? It was so tangible, so strong. I mean, His touch that cuts. Yeah, my right. A touch of manifesting His love that just breaks through. Yeah. You know, love, I said, doesn't hurt. Love saves. Yeah. Love heals. Love never fails. Everything that God does, God so loved the world that He gave. There's something connected that even Paul would say, this love constrains me. Something incredible, how it's the love of God that's the basis of all the breakthroughs that we walk in our lives. And this touch was so strong. He said, I'm reaffirming my stamp. My stamp upon the people. I said, a stamp. You know, and I'm very I don't know what you call that, but maybe because English is a language that I love, I pay attention to every word. So for me, a stamp means that you put it on an envelope because you're about to send it. So you put it on an envelope. So I said, Lord, you're about to send yourself? And He said, yes, my stamp is my seal. tell my people I have sealed them. If they believe in me, they never have to be concerned about taking any other mark, any mark from a beast, any mark from the world, any mark from anybody else. I have sealed them by my spirit as a guarantee of what's to come. My seal, you know, in those days, they would inspect the merchandise and make sure that it was not damaged and it was good to go. And then they would put the seal on the package that they would send. It was huge. It was huge. The whole way they would send things, whether it's a letter who had the seal on it, or whether it was a package, it meant that it was good to go. The scripture tells us that we've been sealed. Sealed with the Holy Spirit. We've been stamped. You know what that means? That means you have his stamps of approval, his stamps of belonging. You know, the seal of the Holy Spirit means that you belong to God. It means that no one can say, no, now you're going to change and take on my seal. Are you kidding? Not only the seal of the Holy Spirit is upon us, and I felt that's so strong, that's why I want to also release that upon you, is because in the times that we live in, this love is going to enable us, the love of God, the love that the scripture says we have to know and believe, the love of God. Sometimes people determine the presence of God, the power of God, based on the way how powerful he is, or on how popular somebody is. Or on how something happened. No, the way that I know somebody belongs to God is according to the scripture, is from the way that they love. This incredible love. That's how I know. Amen? That's how I know. And it's not earned, but it is learned. It is learned from glory to glory. And it enables you even to go through suffering for his name's sake. It enables you to go through stuff, because this love is so overwhelming. It's an incredible, it allows you, you know, perfect love cast out all fear. And fear involves torment. And the scripture tells us that if you have fear, then you have not been perfected in this love. And this word perfected is not perfect the way that we hear it in the natural. It means mature, it means complete. It's teleo, teleo, perfectly perfect, completely complete. It means complete in Christ, nothing missing, nothing lacking. It means that there's something that God does in your life that he says, listen, this is my stamp of approval. This is my stamp of belonging. This is my stamp. You have been bought with a price. You no longer belong to this world. There's been a change of ownership. And that's why the scriptures say, do not love the world, nor the things of the world. But you know how God does that? He does that by increasing his love in and through us. And he enables us through this love. What's amazing to me is that the Holy Spirit, he leads you to press through your fears in order to break through your fears. He will use his love to humble you, to take you through healing, so that you can press through some of the things you fear, and your place of breaking through is as you press through what you fear the most. You fear the most. There's a few nuggets that the Holy Spirit said during this conference. Just a few. There's a whole bunch of this. A few that we talked a lot about love, but in thinking about fear. What I see him do the most when he heals someone is remove that fear. I used to be so bound with fear. What gets me the most in the things that's going on now is how things of the world can bring fear to the people of God. And my prayer, as the Holy Spirit is increasing and releasing an incredible baptism of fire, which is a baptism of love, is that the people of God will be completely fearless. They will have no fear, that they will have boldness in the day of judgment. We're not supposed to have any fear. Fear to love, fear to be hurt, fear to be disappointed. Fear for future, fear for finances, fear for our children, being completely afraid of the next move. That this is not of God. We're supposed to represent the kingdom. We're supposed to represent Him. We're supposed to be so saturated of love that fear has to move the moment that we come into a place. We cannot have any fear. Hallelujah. There's something about facing your fears. I remember when I was telling the Lord I was healed from fear of height. He said, yeah, right. I said, Lord, thank you. You've healed me from fear of height. But then one day I'm driving to Boulder to see my daughter who was attending college there. And he says, I want you to drive up to the mountains. Lord, I told you I was healed. I don't need to prove anything to you. I'm healed for real. Say, no, you need to prove it to yourself. Say, if you truly walk in healing and you know I love you, and you know I am with you, then you're going to start not loving with your words. But the more you grow into the knowledge and you learn of my love, the more you're going to love indeed and in truth. So I said, okay, I'll do that next week. But I get in the car and he says, no. When you hear me and I tell you to do something, a lot of times it's like Abraham. It's now. Get up and go. I didn't tell you yesterday. Now faith is. So drive in the mountains now. I said, I don't know which way to go. He said, so you trust me for tomorrow, but I can't show you the way to go up the mountain? I said, yes, Lord, you show me. But I went. I'll never forget. Because when you press through your fear, yes, whatever it is that you need to confront, there's a manifestation of the tangible anointing of the love that the Holy Spirit has already shed in your heart. Uh-huh. That fear try to put under. Yeah. But as you face it, whatever it is, your relationship, your job, your finances, telling somebody your truth, your tomorrow, whatever it is. Whatever it is. It's like when the IRS calls you. You could wait by fear for weeks to call him back. Or you could call him back, really be fearful of what's going to happen. Right? But the sooner that you press through your fear, you will sense the breakout of His anointing. Yeah. And you will walk through in the breakthrough of that fear. Yeah. So when I got up there, and I stayed in the car and I said, see, Lord, I did it. He said, no, you need to get out. Get out of the car and look down. I said, Lord, I don't know. I don't know. you want me to get out of the car? He said, yes. Opened the door. My hand was shaking a little bit. Because, you know, obeying God doesn't always mean you just, you know. Can I get a witness? You can be shaking, trembling. You're obeying God. Okay, God, I'm going to give them my notice. Okay, God, I'm going to tell her I don't want to see her again. If you're a man of God or, you know, and Delilah is your co-worker. She's blonde, and she wears what everybody wears, which is she goes to work with a bathing suit, low cut, with a see-through on the top. And every day she brings you your paperwork for the day. Can I get you anything else? And vice versa. You woman of God. Every shoulder of every man that you cry on is connected to other parts of that man. Tell it like it is. I've learned a long time ago, I don't want to be in a place with a man by myself. If a pastor invite me to his house, I always say, is your wife going to be there? Amen. 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 And I tell people, if you need prayer, don't get prayed for by a man and there's nobody else around. And you can have that man of God pray for you, but you don't have to put your head on his shoulder. But the moment that you confront your fear and the moment you tell somebody, no, it's not okay for me to do that. Right. Because one of the greatest nuggets in that conference is when the Holy Spirit taught us that we don't have to self-protect, but we can Christ protect. So when you learn that you Christ is in you, the hope of glory, And you press through your fears, and you learn to protect his presence in your life, to be able to set a boundaries. Because if we can't set those little boundaries and say no to those things, how are we going to say no to the mark of the beast? How are we going to say no if there's some things that happen around us and everybody else do it? How are we going to be able to stand and say, no, I don't do that. No, I don't want that. No, I don't need that because I do not love the world. I do not love the world and the things of the world. God doesn't mind you enjoying some of the things in the world. But your love is for him. And I'll never forget opening that door, you know, and try to be sweet and trying to look down like that. Because, you know, there's pressing through your fears and pressing through your fears. You know what I mean? There's a man or a woman setting their boundaries, but not really, you know. Well, this is not a good day. No, tomorrow is the same thing. You better tell her. You better fire her. You can't flee because it's your job. So find somebody else, like a retired lady with a big, big thing all the way here. Right? I mean, let your yes be yes and let your no be no. Don't say no with your words, but, you know, with your action, you know? Woman of God, say no, no. No. No, you have to be so strong. How are we going to stand in this season that we just on the verge of walking through some things that I believe the love of God's going to be so tangible that we're going to see the greatest harvest we've ever seen. I believe that we're going to see some people receiving the love of God like never before, a love that overcomes every obstacle. So to Christ protect means that we don't let fear cause us to move into self-protection, but that we understand his presence, that we don't want to hurt the Holy Spirit. We don't want to grieve him, so we learn to Christ protect. Yes. Another nugget, I'm just going to share with you 3 nuggets in 3 hours. Right. The second nugget that I could see when it comes to love that the Lord said is that the way that you can walk in healing, to be able to walk in that victory, in love, through love, by love, is to understand that what he has done for us heals what the wrong has been done to us, so that we can turn around and do unto others what he has done unto us. That when we learn to focus on his love, it helps us be able to press through the fear. Fear to talk to a boss. Fear to... I'll never forget that day, because I'm standing there and the Holy Spirit, I'm trying to be sweet and look down from up there like that, you know. He said, that's not looking down. I said, it's not, it is. I'm standing. And you know, the Lord, he already knows what you think, what you feel. So, you know, you don't have to come to your Father. You have a personal relationship with him. You don't have to come to him like, you know, you have to protect God. You Christ protect the Christ within. But he doesn't need your protection. You don't need to protect his feelings. Like maybe God's going to get hurt if you tell him you're mad at him. So I said, no, God, I'm looking. He said, no, look down. And I tell you the truth, that anointing came upon me to enable me to look down. And for the first time in my life, I was able to just enjoy and praise him for his creation. Instead of the fear, I just felt his love in such a way that I said, oh, Lord, that is so beautiful. There's a lot of things in our life that we miss out because of fear. We don't take the risk. We don't walk forth. And if we know, as we grow into the knowledge and we learn his love by the precious Holy Spirit, then truly we have no fear to have. As we press through the fear, there will be a breakthrough of the fear. Amen? Hallelujah. To be able to just receive the best and be able to see everything that he created. This love is in such a way that I remember having had to confront my mom. She's with the Lord now. I don't know if they have slot machines in heaven. I don't know if they have slot machine in heaven. I was just trying to see if you guys knew. But I could hear a few people were wondering. I don't know. No, listen, there's no need for slot machines in heaven. Hallelujah. And I'm just making a joke because she's probably hear me and say, listen, Lord, here she's talking about me again. So because I believe that there's going to be a lot of reconciliation and healing in the families, how we press through our fears. And that one day the Holy Spirit says, I want you to confront your mom and tell her how you feel. I said, oh no. I said, she's not gonna understand it. He said, I take care of her. I'm not asking you to do something based on whether she understands it or not. I want you to do it so that you can walk in truth. Wow. And one day after we came back from Black Hawk, and I said, Mom, I want to talk to you. That day she had won a little jackpot. I'm talking to you, Kubia. Huh? She had won a little jackpot, wasn't much, $200, but you know, it was smart to go home before she continues. Bless her heart. The Holy Spirit said, now. Again, now. I said, Mom, when I don't really feel like you understand what I'm starting to do. I had just started going to the school of ministry. So I said, I don't want to go to Black Hawk anymore. I said, you can go if you want, but I cannot go anymore. And some other things, and I started talking to her. It was the most amazing thing, first of all, that she let me talk. But the next thing was that she turns around, she looks at me, and she said, I had no idea why you didn't tell me before. Yeah. And I said, because I was afraid. I was afraid. The last nugget that blessed me through this conference is that the Holy Spirit said the way that we know if we need to receive more of His love is by paying attention to any areas that we have any apprehension, any fear, where we expect a bad outcome. Yes. That's the way you know. If you don't go talk to this person because you're afraid, or I'm scared to, or I'm because the perfect love cast out all fear. And of course, it's from glory to glory, and I can continue to tell you a whole bunch of my business, but I think I'll drink some water and pray for you. Another greatest fear was to answer the call of the ministry. And I was led to pray. I didn't pray to move in signs and wonders. I didn't pray to move in healing. I didn't pray to be able to preach the word. I didn't pray for any of that. But I was led by the Holy Spirit to pray for one thing. I said, Father, I know that in order for me to minister to your people, I need your love. So now I cannot be an under-shepherd. I cannot minister to your people without your love. Not my love, but your love. Your love. I said, it's the greatest commandment. That I love you with my whole heart, my whole mind. Hallelujah. My whole strength, my whole, and then that I can love others, and then that I can love them as myself. And that's what I pray for, you know, like Solomon, he prayed for wisdom. I was led by the Holy Spirit, and I prayed for love. And to this day, sometimes I go through situations that could bring some hurt or some pain, because hurt and pain will come. But you have the ability in God to make a decision so that it doesn't touch you, because you are covered and Christ is in you, the hope of glory, and you're able to walk in forgiveness. And when I started seeing that there was some hurt that could come, my fear, The fear that I started walking in was a little bit like Paul when he says, I come with fear and trembling. That the faith will not be in the power of the Holy Spirit, but that the faith would be in the faith of man. I started to understand, because my fear was that I would receive any kind of hurt and that it would diminish his love. Because then if that happened, then if the enemy uses one person to hurt in any way, and I receive that hurt, then the next person I will not minister to with as much tangible love. Are you following me? I'm telling you real stuff here that probably other pastors go through, but they won't tell you. And other pastors I know that I minister to receive this hurt. Yes, because it's the greatest thing that you can pray to for yourself, not just as a pastor, because you don't want the next relationship that you have to receive whatever hurt you have from somebody else. You need to have his love in and through you like never before. The whole conference was to be able to love again. Not just another mate, but for you to love the mate that you have in new ways. Don't raise your hand, but I'm wondering how many men of valor were not here that your wife came to this conference and went home and was completely different. Don't raise your hand. Because you might go home and have a different kind of lunch. But it could also be relationship with a friend, with a sister in the Lord, with your children, with your grandchildren. Amen. I'm going to close because I want to pray for each and every one that can stay and receive just this incredible touch. Hallelujah. And I know you have launch plans, but I pray that we can play that song again because I feel something that needs to be loose. I think it's located like somewhere. Hallelujah. Lift up your hands. The precious Holy Spirit is here. Say, Father, thank you for your love. We love you because you first loved us. We receive your love today by faith. Even if we don't feel it, we believe it. We believe it. And we thank you for it. And as you stamp us, as we know that we are sealed, thank you that we will press through every fear, to break through every fear, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment, boldness, all fear to be cast out, that you may be glorified. And Father, today, as we praise you, we come against the enemy. We have no fear. We command you, bow down. The name of Jesus is above all name. We take authority and we declare we have the victory in Christ Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. No fear. Hallelujah.